Two ADF rebels have been killed and their commander, known as Njovu, arrested following a successful operation by the UPDF on Lake Edward in Kasese. The commander of the Operation Shuja, Major General Dick Olum, confirmed the incident and explained that the operation was jointly mounted by the Marine Police.
2 Brigade based in Hima, and today it is AORA. I'm sure he may have some peace, he will have some rest now that this guy has been looking for, is virtually has been caught and the rest killed. So we think there has been a great operation undertaken by the chieftains of military intelligence, guiding the operation force, guiding my force, until we came in touch with this. Of course, this has been a very superb operation, guided by His Excellency the President, where we got a number of special forces which also came into play, the Marines of the UPDF. I mean, it was a joint operation that really was led by intelligence, and we've come out eventually with the results.
According to Major General Dick Olum, they got intelligence reports that the ADF were again planning to cross to Uganda through Katwe Kabatoro, and they waylaid them on the waters.
So for all this time, we have been looking for these thugs, especially these ones who killed the tourists. They've always eluded us, but this time somehow, last evening we got very good information about their movements and probably trying to move from somewhere to other areas. We hit them, but somehow it was in the middle of the water with boats, so we wouldn't get the proper result.
The rebels were found with items including nails, torches, solar panels used to manufacture explosives, uniforms, magazines with ammunition. Major General Dick Olum explained that they suspected that the rebels were 7 in number, but they managed to find the bodies of only 2 rebels and arrested one. He added that they did not recover any gun because they could have drowned into the waters of Lake Edward on the Ugandan side.
And today, after all this search, with intelligence information, clear intelligence information, which I should clarify here, searching for these thugs, because they are only 6 and 7 in number, it has been a hard task to get them.
The LC3 chairperson for Katwe Kabatoro Town Council, John Bosco Kananura, said that they had bullets rocking the area at around 1 a.m. He revealed that they agreed with the army to bury the rebels at the town council cemetery as the commander was taken to Rusese Army Barracks in Impondwe Luhia Town Council in Kasese District.
I think around about 1, some few minutes past 1, that's when I got a phone call to the effect that these people had been captured. Some people were put out of action, the rebels actually. So that's what happened throughout the night.
Commenting about the operation, Bakali Sibowa hailed the army for the operation and said that their action is going to give life to the tourism sector.
The chintu cha UPTF ya kora ni chintu cha amani muno. Kani tuwentu chinihira kurugira mpresidentu wetu ngetu kumwesiga. Tuwentu nihira chintu chino kuvahu.
Major General Dick Olum later addressed locals who had gathered to witness the incident and urged them to always report any suspicious people in the community. The Minister of Defense Deputy Spokesperson, Deo Akik, confirmed the incident and revealed that the UPDF is doing everything possible to wipe the country of any terror activities.
To get these ADF elements started away in the night, so between 3 and 4 o'clock, that's when the attack took place. And the operation was still going on to make sure that anybody who could have remained is got.
Relatedly, the International Crimes Division of the High Court has sentenced 4 ADF collaborators to 7 years imprisonment after they pleaded guilty to 9 counts related to terrorism. The 4, who include Faizwali Diksoka, Saruti Yona Muhindo, Musa Kamia and Farouk Agaba, had been on remand for 4 years. The accused persons were arrested from several parts of the country, including Elgon region, Busoga, Bokedi, among others. But with the help of senior prosecutor Thomas Jatiko, they entered a plea bargain to get a lighter sentence. Muzami Mukwaya, who rejected the plea bargain, is still on remand as he makes up his mind on whether to plead guilty or continue with the trial. Report compiled by Gilbert Mohanguzi, Samuel Manyire, and Rachel Nachiwala for the news.